of running over a woman multiple times in a parking lot of a Exchange of Order One Sigurtamante has won. Police tell us a woman staying at this home on Walsham Road, 89-year-old John Bogard, was arguing. It escalated, and when the woman started walking away, Bogard followed her in his car and ran over her.
He was apparently driving over, backing up.
This all unfolding in broad daylight and in the parking lot of Walsham Elementary School.
Two of the witnesses were passing by, saw this occurring, stopped their vehicle, got out, and they were seen with handgun holders and began firing at the individual that was running over the scene.
One of the witnesses shot out the front tire of his car, but Bogard got away. Police say he was later arrested at his home on Windway Drive.
Well, that's sad, you know what I mean? How can people be so scared, you know? So you were there laying in the parking lot.
Simon Villa, a pastor at a local church, rushed out to the scene when he heard the news.
She attended a couple of times at church, and she went to the wellness church, lady. We helped her out with some things. And when she had a problem, she went and talked to her grandmother.
He says he hopes her family gets justice.
Be safe out here, you know. People are crazy out here.
Roxy Bismonte, Ken's 5, Eyewitness News.
A jewelry store robbery leads to a lockdown at Rolling Oaks Mall. San Antonio police responded to a 911 call at the mall around 6 o'clock last night. The police did make an arrest, but tell us no shots were fired. This robbery is very similar to one in January of 2017. Same mall that left one man dead. In that one, two men tried to rob the K Jewelers store. And as they left, two shoppers tried to stop them. One of those men was shot and killed, while the other robber managed, Fifth American managed to shoot the suspect. The Carry the Load West Coast Relay, which is now Texas, began on April 27th in Seattle. The group's mission is to bring back the true meaning of Memorial Day. Eyewitness News reporter Jeremy Baker has more on the big rally here in San Antonio. Everyone is invited to attend.
That's the Carry the Load West Coast Relay and volunteers who joined it to walk its first 2-mile leg in Seattle over 3 weeks ago. And they've traveled far.
We're so excited to be here in San Antonio to welcome our West Coast Relay team.
And along with the East Coast Relay team, which started its walk on May 1st in West Point, New York. They are stopping in dozens of cities for Carry the Load rallies.
What started in 2011 has grown to include over 50 rally cities this year.
San Antonio gets the Carry the Load spotlight after the West Coast team arrives in the Alamo City and the start of a 1.5-mile walk from the La Quinta River Walk just off I-37, starting at 11:30, ending at noon with a 2-hour rally at La Villita.
It's going to be family-friendly. We're going to have festivities, live music, inspirational speeches.
The West Coast Relay team will be there.
I'm Travis Swain. I am the West Coast Relay Manager for Carry the Load.
As will the Carry the Load bus. And the team hopes you'll be there, too, to help honor the sacrifices of our nation's heroes.
The military, law enforcement, firefighters, and rescue personnel and their families who sacrifice for us every day.
I am carrying Colonel Chuck Schretzman. U.S. Army Special Forces, who has just been diagnosed with ALS.
Debbie Bunning from Dallas says this rally in San Antonio is the perfect way to honor those like Colonel Schretzman.
What a perfect way to show up tomorrow and help support all these great heroes.
The walk will end here at La Vita Warren Plaza at about noon. Festivities will run until 2 o'clock. That's when the relay team once again hits the road and heads on to Houston. At La Vita, Jeremy Baker, Ken's 5, Eyewitness News.
San Antonio continues to honor and remember fallen firefighter Scott Bean. Tonight, you can help carry on his legacy on the ice. The San Antonio Fire Department is taking on the Dallas Police Department in the inaugural Public Safety Ice. The game is this afternoon at Northwest Ice Center. Tickets are $10, and they'll be auctioning off special Scott Bean jerseys. Proceeds will benefit the responders' first foundation. San Antonio Petco Lodge is trying to help find 100 furry friends for a forever home. Dozens of puppies and kittens are up for adoption today. The organization is offering 25% off all adoption fees this weekend. The goal is to place 100 cats and dogs with their loved ones in care.
I think it's so important to adopt. My heart, but I also know what great animals are here, and that hopefully they find their place in it.
School is almost out and it's not too late to make summer camp plans, a place just for girls with activities to keep them going all summer.
Jason Thompson, General Manager of Enzer Nissan. Let me show you how to buy your next new car online in just 30 seconds. Just go to EnzerNissanSA.com. Find the vehicle you want. Now click on the Buy Online button. Choose upgrades. Add a trade-in if you would like. Select the store. We will deliver to your home. And that's it. Buy a new Nissan during the